Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yank here, and welcome to the finale of Let's Play Banjo-Tooie. So, we've collected all 90 Gs and all 900 notes, and right now, we are ready and raring to go into the final world of the game, Cauldron Keep, and take on Grunty for hopefully the second and final time. So, without further ado, let's head on inside the final world in the game. Alright, so like I said, Cauldron Keep is technically the final world in the game, but there is really nothing to collect here. It's just basically getting down this giant drawbridge and getting on inside, taking on Grunty for the final challenge. So, and yes, there's a warp head right here. That's to easily get onto the top of the tower, because as you saw in the last part, we actually had to deactivate another little defense of Grunty's with the 70 Jiggies, I believe. So, yeah, even if you got through here, you would still have to collect 70 Jiggies anyway, so good thing we got that taken care of, right? So, basically use the sack pack to get on over with Banjo over there to go on that switch, and now we'll just go on this switch with Kazooie, and that will hopefully, then that will actually lower the bridge. There we go, and it's actually got a double safe thing going on there. Why would you have a freaking electrical fence with the drawbridge already down? Hey, that Grunty's pretty crafty, so let's just reunite right here and go on around, and uh-oh, she's got a guard. So here it is, Banjo-Kazooie, final showdown with the Minjo, and oh my god, is his body still in there? Oh Jesus, my freaking grenade egg like ricocheted off the wall and just sent that Minjo into the acid pool of death. Oh man, that was very sad. I salute thee, Minjo. You were a very worthy adversary throughout the whole entire— oh god, he's back! Okay, let's leave. Let's leave now before we get hurt. So that's it with the Minjos. I don't know where they came from or what their purpose is in life, but that is what happens when you go on the acid. Okay. Good, I showed that off, and I still have the honey back cheat on, so booyakasha. It's gonna make this little last fight that much easier. And I have another cheat activated as well, so I'll be showing that off, hopefully, in this thing. The gatehouse. Hey, Kazooie, there doesn't appear to be anyone in here. Well, Banjo, you are right, but as Kazooie points out, ah, yes, there is. The music's changed. Every time that happens, we always end up fighting. Ah, I just love the fourth wall breaking here. Yarr, Klungo must have been Mistress's Grunty Castle. Ah, Klungo, career questioning minion. Just give it up, man. You look so beaten up. Don't you ever learn. Klungo clever. Learn lots. Has learned new potion. Is it as useless as all the others? Yes, sir. Klungo means no. Must win this time or Mistress feed me to monster. What monster? I didn't see Grunty having a monster. Klungo, I think she's lying. But yeah, he's gonna drink that blue potion. Oh no, and it's gonna make him divide. So he's gonna hit the original. And I'll show off what I actually activated. There we go. Basically, I have the homing eggs cheat on now. Basically, to get that cheat, we had to collect all the stop and swap eggs and bring them to Heggy, and she would give us that cheat. So, and we just gotta make sure we hit the right ones. Make some divide. We wanna hit the right one. There we go. So on in off screen, I actually got that cheat. And as well, I got the extra honeycomb, because we had 9 empty honeycombs just lying around. I forgot to go to Honey Bee and exchange them, so it's a good thing we got them, right? I think it's this one. Let's see. Oh, nice shot. There we go. Regular eggs for the win right there to finish him, too. And there we go. Klungo is defeated. That potion was pretty good, but not good enough. Not good enough. Klungo noticed something happening after fights with Bear and Bird. And that is? Klungo gets less and less handsome. Now Miss Klungo won't want me anymore. Oh, he's married. Aw, good for you, guy. At least you have something going for you. Klungo had enough. So what are you gonna do now, big guy? Future prospects not good with Mistress. We can always be like a stand-in for the Hulk. Be a stunt double. No chance of promotion. No days off. No pay. Klungo go find easy desk job. Maybe make stupid games. Ah, gotta love that fourth wall breaking. You are clever, Rare. You are clever, and it's a shame that you are no longer a company anymore, but you are with Microsoft. Okay, let's not go down that road. Let's go down this road, the Tower of Tragedy, this game's version of Fiery Furnace Fun. And it's a quiz, of course. Come on, what Banjo-Kazooie game would be incomplete, or be complete without a quiz? Thank you, I'm Grunty. You're okay, I'm not gonna talk in that voice. Basically, we're gonna have a little quiz show right here. Unlike Grunty's Fire Furnace Fun, I think that was right, it's not a board game, it's more of a game show. So basically, To move on to the next round, we have to answer all the questions right, obviously, get a lot of points, don't have the lowest score, because if you have the lowest score at the end of each round, you will be eliminated. Correct answers score 2 points, with 1 point being awarded if it was a second guess, basically a steal. And incorrect answer is basically, I think, a -2, so we don't want to get anything wrong. Yeah, take 2 points away, that's not good at all. So we're going up against her sisters, and X is to buzz in, and an A is to make the answer, obviously, from the choices. And let's meet tonight's victims, or I mean contestants, shall we? Introducing on the left, it's my gorgeous, slim sister, Mingella. On the right, we have my lovely, shapely sister, Blabelda. And in the middle, just some loser bear called Banjo. Oh, even the audience still hates us. Let's start round one. What is the name of the quiz I haven't hosted? Okay, she's done Grunty's Fire Furnacy Fun and beat the bear. Not a big quiz. So yeah, I'm gonna be a little discombobulated right here because I'll have questions to answer. Ah! I didn't answer in time. So yeah, this is where the commentary is gonna take a dive, but I gotta stay focused and get this quiz right. Who worked in the train's boiler? Okay, oh, it's old King Cole. Man, they answer fast. Yeah, they really buzz in fast, so you just gotta get on top of that. And okay, basically we have some scenes we can look at. Alright, I'll see right here. Hieroglyphics. I hear money going around. This has gotta be Mayhem Temple. What are they gonna ask? Are they ask something specific about the picture? Where would you see this in Mayhem Temple? That is in the treasure chamber wall. There we go. Not bad. Awesome. Alright, so here's a scene from a game. Okay, let's see. That is in Wumba's hut. Let's just make sure. They sometimes ask like what the triangles are, what the colors are. You just gotta make sure you get everything there. How many yellow arrows? 3. None. Okay, I didn't think it would be a trick question. There we go. Alright, what giant-footed dinosaur tries to crush you in Pterodactyland? That would be the Stomponodon. Not a real dinosaur, though. I'm a know-it-all, I know. What is Colkin Cole announced as in Glitter Gold Shmine? That would be Master of the Mining. I didn't know that one. Hmm. Clubby Boiler. It might be the middle one, actually. Yeah, I thought I knew that, actually. Mm. Oh, well, we got one wrong. What are you gonna do? Alright, so what shape is the stand that I'm reading? Oh, God. Star shape? There we go, okay. Yeah, some of these questions are just really out there. What can be found in Isle of Hags Quagmire? Oh, come on, I didn't even get time to answer that. I knew that one, too. Alright, what name is on the locker that you could enter? Okay, you buzzed in before she even finished the question. That's not fair. What color are the Clockwork Kazooie eggs? That's red and with yellow spots. Okay. Yep, I'll accept that. Alright, so show us another scene. Where have we been? Oh, it's Pano's. Alright, so Pano's got a yellow brim hat, striped shirt, cash register. What else are you gonna ask me? Where is this? Okay, that's Pano's. Good. I thought they were gonna ask me a really out there question. Where does King Jingling live? That's Jinjo Village in a throne room, I guess. Okay, there we go. So yeah, just great commentary right here. Where's Lord Food Falcon announced right here? Self-important angler fish. So yeah, you shouldn't have too much trouble in this quiz show. What spells? Oh man, come on. Yeah, turn lead to gold. I would love to see that. Well, me and Mumbo could start a side business. What? I didn't read the question. Prizes from my last quiz. Grunties. I don't even know. Oh, it's who had the prize. Oh, okay. I thought it said like who made appearance. I knew it was Pawner. He had that thing in the stand. I don't know. I'm just gonna let this go down. I already won this round, so there's no point buzzing in. And whoa, there's a tie. I wonder how this is actually gonna go down. Hmm. Oh goody, round one's a draw. I'll just unfairly select a loser at random. I choose Mingella! Oh wow, I've never seen an actual tie before. That's pretty cool, she just chooses. I just love how she has her sisters enter this sadistic game show, like which would get squished. Move on to round two. Like she couldn't get anyone else, maybe Mumbo? Could have been a game of like Saw right here. Oh, come on, I buzzed in. I knew it was red. Yeah, so let's see what we can do here. Let's look at the screen. That is the code chamber, okay. Oh, don't ask me like what letter was in which position. Oh, real fair game. Like that's, come on. How many chimneys does a factory have? Oh God, two? There we go, okay. That was a tough one. It's kind of like how many chimneys the rusty bucket had. Enlarge? Yeah, bubonic plague. Okay. Made enlarge that much easier to guess. Alright, so what scene is this? Oh, hey, it's Jolly dancing around. Maybe I'll be doing that when I be grunty. Okay, probably not. Oh, come on. Jolly J, Jolly Jimmy. Oh, come on. Some of these guesses are just absurd. Alright, so what we got now? Running shoes, it looks like Pterodactyl Land. Really gonna ask? Oh, come on! Get the hell out! No, come on! Get the heck out of here. Drill? Okay, good. If I got that one right there, I would've been in trouble. What's found inside Clackable Land's Pot of Gold? That would be a shooting game. Alright, on a roll now, let's do it. Yeah, I've gotten like 30 points at one time in this game, but right now I'm just focusing and doing this at the same time. It's a little hard. Okay, rare Banjo. Come on! How many times did Banjo defeat Klungo? That would be 3. Okay, tie game. Let's do it. Anyone's game. Who owns the sacred temple where it's... Oh. Thank you! God dang. That would be Jiggy Wiggy, Master Jig Jag. Okay, that really narrowed it down. Alright, so let's take a look at this scene. 60 seconds left. Pterodactyl Land again, okay. How many bones? Yeah, I'm just gonna sigh now. That's all I'm gonna do. Alright, let's take a look at this scene. Right, that's on top of the Tarkanzan's temple. So, let's see. What can the statue do? It held the Jiggy. Alright, so there we go. 13 to 10. I'm up by 3. That's 2-point possession. Turn. I don't know what I was trying to say. We score 1. Okay. I was trying to say it was a 2-possession game. There we go. Let's look at the screen, shall we? That is an... Wow, a lot of Mayhem Temple questions. So that's still Berta, the mole that got trapped. Let's see what the question is. What color is the rat's hat? That is yellow. Cyan. It's like an odd color that they put there. Where would you find a big oil drill? That would be in Hellfire Peak's icy side. Now we're just running away with it. And that is the end of the game and last question. So this is just for bragging, right? So what do we got? Ancient Beard Camel. Okay, this is Witchy World. Mighty Evil Dinosaur. Weird Killer Alien. What do we got? What was actually in the Weird Killer Alien? It was a Jinjo. Mumbo Jumbo, yes. I missed the last one, too. That would've been funny. And that's the end of round 2. Looks like my sister Blob Belda has also failed to beat that dumb bear. Here's your consolation prize, Blobby. Alright, so we won this quiz show. Much easier than Fiery Furnace Fun. And it's really easy, and we got past it. Cool. Now listen, Dunce, I'm changing the rules for the final round. What? There's a final round? I thought I just won. To make it harder, I won't show you the answers unless you buzz in. So we got a lightning round right here. A little bit of a curveball, but still, I think it's easier than Fiery Furnace Fun. And we can pass the question, so that makes it a little easier. So, yeah, we gotta beat the score of how many? I wish you plenty of bad luck. I think we have to beat like 15 points, 14 points. Alright, so it's the final round. Banjo lost or Grunty something. What is the name of the world 2? That is Glurgulch Mine. We gotta beat 15 points. We got 170 seconds to go. Which was a problem that family kids had? They were too... Oh. Sickness? Well, I mean, like, the... There was a lot of problems in that family. What's the combination? 1984. Alright, so we gotta get a move on right there with that failed question. We'll call our Banjo shorts. I wonder. It's yellow. Okay, I don't know why I was scrolling around and dicking around there. Alright, so how many kickball coaches offer advice in Mayhem Temple? Pass. Alright, so it takes a little time to pass, a little bit of a penalty. Wary does not exist in Pterodactyl Land. That would be the hatchery. I think that's Heggy's. Who is Tarkanzan the Nine God of? Target shooting? Okay, good. Halfway there, baby. What fairground fast food is not available? Burgers, fries, donuts is not available. Alright, so 5 to go. What was Mayhem Temple's treasure chamber officially looking for? Official look for. Cheap trinket thing. Price of relic thing. There we go. Almost ran out of time, too. Which character was an exhibit in Witchy World's Cave of Horrors? That would be Gobi the Camel. So, yeah, these questions are. They're not honest, they're pretty, they're not, I don't know, it's better than the last game. I'll just, hold on, question, warning, powerful magnet, oh, come, wasn't any magnet question, too? Which is a weapon used by the flanker, hot dogs, a candy cane, there we go, it's one of those three. What was wrong with pterodactyl lands? Lived in the hole. Thirsty. Alright, so we got the game in hand. Basically, we can just coast from here. What's unusual by Master Jiggy Wiggy? He raps, he's got a Jiggy for a head. Oh, Jiggy Wiggy, he's got a Jiggy for a head. Thought it was saying Jing-a-Lang. What items did the pawnbroker at Jolly Roger's Lagoon have for sale? That would be a Cheeto page. So yeah, I'm just gonna coast right here and just stop talking about the questions, and since I've already won. Deactivated, using egg between the eyes. Basically, like I said, this is the questions are on the same level as the last game throughout the game. They ask you these bunch of questions too. It's part of it. But I think Fiery Furnace Fun is way harder because you got mini games to deal with. You have that game over pad, right? You can fall on the board game. Let's see, chocolate? Out, whatever. We've won already. But yeah, it's definitely easier than Grunty's for Fiery Furnace Fun. Let's see. Summon? Okay, good. And 10 seconds left. Let's see what the last question is. What is the name of a dinosaur lived in Pterodactyl Lands? Interior Lake. That would be Dippy. Wait, no. Interior Lake? I don't know. I thought it was Dippy. Oh well, who cares? We won. Alright, so that's the end of the final round. What a useless score that... Huh? What's wrong with the scoring system? It must be broken. You can't have gotten that many points. No, 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 no. I declare the win invalid due to faulty equipment. Oh, dear. So what happens now? I don't know. Any ideas? You could escape in a cowardly fashion like in Banjo-Kazooie before we kick your bony butt. Yes, I could. Thanks, Bird Brain. Fortunately, I've been able to rocket into my booth for this very reason. I'll be waiting for you at the top like last time, but this time you'll be the ones taking the fall. And there she goes, running away like last time. We can get inside the gun chamber now, and since we'll be in the quiz show, right, come on, Kazooie, let's go and see where that door let's just open leads to. Do you reckon that's the end of the game? I don't know, Kazooie, maybe it is, maybe I just won. I doubt it. We've not seen the credits yet. True, Banjo. That's true. Okay, let's go. Alright, so we missed getting crushed to death then. Let's head inside the gun control room and it's credits time. Here we go. In memory of Chris Melander. Sorry for mispronouncing your name. As memoriam. Definitely a good guy. Probably did something toward this game, so thank you very much. So, yes, that was it, Banjo-Tooie being the quiz show, and just like in Banjo-Kazooie fashion, we get the credits. And after the credits, we'll take on Grunty. But for now, let's just enjoy the game and give credit where credit was due. I would like to first say thank you to, actually, Greg Males. That's who I wanted to make sure I said. And Grand Old King Kirkhope, I'll get to you. But yeah, Greg Males, he's a guy that really doesn't get a lot of credit. When you think of Banjo-Kazooie, Banjo-Tooie, you always think of, like, Grant Kirkhope, the Stamper Brothers, but that's a guy that really deserves credit, like, right there, Greg Grunty Males. He actually designed Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie, the game design element. He made all the levels, everything in it. And, believe it or not, he actually made Diddy. He was one of the guys behind making the character Diddy in Donkey Kong Country. So, yeah, he actually did a lot at his time at Rare, and he actually helped make Donkey Kong 64. I'm not sure about his other works. Maybe he helped with Conker. But yeah, I just wanted to make sure I got his name out there because he really doesn't get mentioned a lot and definitely deserved it because he basically made the game. So yeah, kudos to him and the Stamper Brothers once again. You guys were great at Rare. I wish you were still making games at Rare and it was still awesome and whatnot. And of course, Grant Kirkhope, amazing score once again, and you're still doing a heck of a job doing the games you're doing right now. And let's just see what we're looking at right now. Yeah, we just got a slideshow right here of all the places we've been. In Banjo-Kazooie, it was actually a little slideshow of all the characters in the game. I kind of missed that. I would like to see the character parade because, I don't know, Rare has a thing with doing the character parade. They did that in Donkey Kong Country as well. And it would have been nice here, but now we just get a slideshow of all the places we've been, which isn't as satisfying, but oh well, what are you going to do? I mean, it's still satisfying to hear this music, so Yeah, this ending credits theme is great. Once again, Frank Kirkhope. Oh, Chris Parnell Seaver, and the Stamper Brothers. Basically, Seaver is the guy, I believe, who made, I think he made Conker's Bad Fur Day. Don't quote me on that. But I know he's a pretty important guy at Rare, and he made, I think, a game or two. So yeah, he's definitely important. I don't want to say he made something if he didn't, so I'm pretty sure he did. But, yeah, don't quote me on that. We're going to get some Xbox Live guys who made this game. And they definitely deserve a lot of credit. That was actually pretty cool of Microsoft to actually get this game onto the Xbox 360. I mean, since they acquired Rare's, basically intellectual property of Banjo-Kazooie, they actually did a good thing in making HD remakes of the original two games, which is amazing. They may have messed up on that sequel. We will not mention that game is not really a sequel, in my opinion. Still waiting for Banjo 3, but yeah, they definitely did a good job in making these games HD and making them look fantastic. And oh, Steve Mails too. He had a little brother. Okay, I forgot about that. So he helped out. But yes, now that we're done talking about the people who made the game, let's talk about the people who have been watching my Let's Play. Yeah, thank you guys so much. You've been so supportive throughout this whole Let's Play. It's actually become one of my more popular ones. A lot of people I've been seeing a lot more viewers watching my Let's Play this, I've noticed, over the last, month or two. And I just want to thank you guys so much. I didn't really see that coming. I mean, Banjo-Kazooie, my Let's Play of that was pretty tame. It was, a decent amount of viewers. But this one, it was, double that. That was amazing. It's probably the most viewers I've ever had in the Let's Play, so I just want to thank you guys that. The comments you've been leaving are very supportive as well. Been appreciating that immensely. And I just want to thank you guys for making this one of my favorite Let's Plays, actually. If I had to go back and say, I think this is probably my favorite Let's Play I've ever made. With that Stop and Swap video I made as a throwback to when I did Banjo-Kazooie. That was a great video. That was probably one of the best videos I think I've ever made, and one of the videos I'm most proud of on my channel. And I just think every video that I made for Banjo-Tooie was just hit after hit. I mean, I've been recently very hard on myself on recording. Basically, at the start of this finale video, I probably did at least 100 takes. I'm not even joking. I am very, very hard on myself. I'm a bit of a perfectionist, and I just had to get it right for you guys. I mean, this is the finale. I wanted to make this part perfect and great. And I'm kind of pissed that during the quiz show, I kind of was bad with my commentary, but I mean, when I'm playing the game, it just goes back to I'm very bad at commentating while playing the game and focusing. And I'm just curious how the final boss is going to be, and that's why I decided to make this live commentary, by the way. I did post in a couple parts before this, but this one I wanted to make live, because it is a special part, it is the finale, and you guys really deserve that. And I just wanted to mention, there's actually going to be a bonus part after this finale video. Basically, the finale is split up into two different parts, if you've noticed, by the title, obviously. And after the finale is done with, there's going to be a bonus video of things that I got. Basically, the jukebox I want to show off, Jiggy Wiggy's sanctum, I guess you would say, his area. There's actually something I didn't show off, which I will. And some other things I missed and wanted to show off as well, and maybe some bloopers, actually, because I actually had quite a bit leading up to this part, so maybe I'll show that off, one or two parts of it. So I don't want to make it too long, but yeah, expect another part after the finale, and then we are officially done with Banjo-Tooie, and we are moving on to Kingdom Hearts. We're getting back to Kingdom Hearts 2, and that'll actually, fall on Valentine's Day, so Kingdom Hearts, Valentine's Day, I mean, how cool is that? That coincided. That's actually a year anniversary since I started Kingdom Hearts 2. And yeah, a lot of people have been requesting, have been asking when I'll be coming back. Yeah, we're gonna be getting back into that, and I want to finish my other Let's Plays I haven't finished. So basically, yeah, 2014 is the year I complete unfinished Let's Plays. I still have Pokemon Crystal to complete, and I still have, what is it? I even forgot. Pokemon Crystal, I Fallout 3 from a while ago. I'm probably not gonna finish that, though. And I had, what was it? It really just escaped my mind. Oh, Donkey Kong Country 2. I was speaking of Donkey Kong Country and Rare. I gotta finish that. I was really close to the end, too, so maybe I'll stream, I don't know, maybe I'll stream them, maybe I'll just make them as the Let's Play parts again, just continue from there. Because it'd be kind of confusing to, continue from a Let's Play you've, haven't done in months. So I gotta find a way to, mesh that together. And as we're nearing the end of the credits, yeah, we're about to get to the final area and take on Grunty for the final battle in the game. And yes, this was made in 2009. That was great. That's actually where I first started Let's Playing, so that was pretty cool. And all rights reserved, and that